What if I told you that with just a 555 timer chip, a few inexpensive components, and a bit of creativity, you could build your own laser ray at home? Let's fire it up! Hey guys! In this video, I'll show you how to make a laser ray using the 555 timer IC. Stay tuned to the second part of this video where I'll explain how this circuit works. I've packed my favorite 555 timer projects into a free ebook. Yep, totally free. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 2 alligator clips, 6 jumper wires, 1 220,000 ohm resistor, 1 470 ohm resistor, 1 10 microfarad capacitor, 1 0.1 microfarad ceramic capacitor, 1 white LED, 1 555 timer IC, a 9 volt battery, a 9 volt battery buckle connector, 1 5-watt speaker, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Starting from the top left is pin 1, which is ground or the ground supply. Pin 2 is trigger. It is used to start the timing interval in both monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 is output. It delivers the result of the timer's operation based on its mode, either monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4 is reset. It is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 is control. It allows you to control the threshold voltage levels that the internal comparators use to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6 is threshold. It monitors the voltage of the capacitor connected to the circuit. Pin 7 is discharge. It controls the charge and discharge cycle of the timing capacitor. Pin 8 is VCC. It is responsible for supplying the power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Start by placing the 555 timer IC onto the breadboard. Remember, the pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Insert a 0.1 microfarad capacitor into pin 2, or trigger and the negative rail. Since ceramic capacitors don't have polarity, you can insert either leg into pin 2. Bend the ends of a 220 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 220 kilo ohm resistor into pin 3, or output in pin 6 or threshold. Insert a 10 microfarad capacitor into pin 3 or output and a few rows below it. The anode is in pin 3. Bend the ends of a 470 ohm resistor. Insert the 470 ohm resistor into pin 3. Or output in a few rows below the 555 timer. Insert a white LED into pin 5 or control in the same row as the resistor. The anode is in pin 5. Insert a jumper wire into the same row as the 10 microfarad capacitor. Attach the jumper wire to the alligator clip. Insert a jumper wire into the negative rail. Attach the jumper wire to the alligator clip. Connect the other ends of the alligator clips to the terminals of the 5-watt speaker. Attach the buckle connector to the 9-volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Connect the positive lead of the battery holder to the positive rail. Connect the negative lead of the battery holder to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This laser ray circuit uses a 555 timer IC configured in a stable mode to generate a continuous square wave. Powered by a 9-volt battery, the 555 timer produces a pulsing output that simultaneously controls an LED and a small speaker to simulate a sci-fi laser ray effect. The main components include a 220 kilo-ohm resistor, a 100 nanofarad capacitor, and a 470 ohm resistor, along with a 10 microfarad capacitor and a 5-watt speaker. The 555 timer is set up so that pins 2 and 6 are connected, allowing the capacitor to charge and discharge repeatedly through the resistor. This creates oscillations at pin 3 or output. The reset pin or pin 4 is tied to the power supply to keep the timer active, while the control voltage pin or pin 5 is grounded to improve stability. As the 555 timer oscillates, the output signal drives the LED through the 470 ohm resistor, causing it to blink rapidly. At the same time, the square wave signal is sent through the 10 microfarad capacitor to the speaker. This causes the speaker to emit short bursts of sound in sync with the LEDs flashing, producing a classic laser gun sound effect. The frequency of the oscillation is determined by the 220 kilo-ohm resistor and the 100 nanofarad capacitor. Based on the standard formula for a 555 timer in a stable mode, the output frequency is around 65 Hz, which gives a low pulsing sound. The combination of blinking light and matching audio makes this circuit ideal for fun DIY projects that mimic a laser ray. I hope this video has shown you how to make a laser ray circuit with a 555 timer IC. Want to dive deeper into 555 timer projects? Grab my free ebook packed with awesome circuits and ideas. Just click the link in the description to download your copy now. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.